Amen. Our Father and our God, in the name of Jesus, we thank you, we honor and adore you for who you are. Thank you, Father, for yet another opportunity to be found in your presence. Lord, we don't take this chance for granted, because we know many, Father, desire such a time, such a day like this, but they are no more. I thank you, Father, and I bless your name for your faithfulness upon each and every one of us that are found in your presence, our Father, this morning. It is a cold morning, but Lord, you have granted us a chance to be in your house. Great is your faithfulness, our Father, in the name of Jesus. Utukuzwe Bwana, uinuliwe katika jina la Yesu Kristo. Asante kwa wema wako, uaminifu wako, mfalme. Umetulinda, umetuhifadhi, umetuchunga wiki yote. Na Bwana umekuwa mwaminifu kupigana vita vyetu. Pokea sifa, uinuliwe, utukuzwe milele Bwana. Tunapo Bwana anza ibada hii, tunaomba ukaanze pamoja nasi. Roho Mtakatifu wa Bwana, tuwezi kuendelea kwa ibada hii bila wewe. Katika jina la Yesu Kristo, ukatuongoze katika kuabudu, kusifu, hata kusikia neno kukutolea Bwana. Kwa kila jambo utakalolitenda kwa ibada hii, tunaomba ya kwamba ukapokee sifa mfalme. It is not about us, but God Almighty. We pray that it will be about you. Be the center of this service in the name of Jesus. Take preeminence, our Father, in the name of Jesus Christ. Take preeminence in our minds, O God, in our hearts, O Jehovah God, in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And we let down every plan of the enemy powerless, and we declare and decree, Jehovah God, that no weapon fashioned against us, against this service, that shall prevail. In the mighty name of the Lord Jesus, our desire, O God, is to worship you in truthful, O God, in truth and in spirit, in the name of Jesus. And we thank you and we bless your holy name, Jehovah God, for every plan of the enemy, O God, shall not prevail in Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, because, Lord, we are not going to leave this place the same way we are coming, O dear God, for healing is found in your presence. Deliverance is found in your presence, O God, in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus, and in the mountain of the Lord it shall be provided. And we are in your mountain, our Father, and so we believe and trust and abide, God, knowing that we are not coming out the same, in the name of Jesus. For chains are going to be broken in the name of Jesus. We are going to fall in Jesus' mighty name, and we are going to be set free, our Father, in this service, in the name of the Lord Jesus. Father, we bless your name. We give you praise. You are the King of Kings. You are the Great I Am. Thank you for us that are already in. Them that are on the way coming, quicken their faith that we continue together. Thank you for your servant, for anointing and preparing him to speak the oracles to us. Prepare our hearts, our ears of understanding, that we may get to hear from you, even as we continue. Lord, help us, Holy Spirit, to worship in truth and in spirit. Help even our viewers, O God, that we may join together in praising and worshiping you in Jesus' mighty name. We bless you and we honor you. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Let's celebrate Jesus. opportunity that God is about to speak to you and me. And may you open your ears, our viewers. May you also open your ears, because the Lord is about to speak and let my word, and it will change and transform your life. So let's honor his servant, our senior pastor, even as he comes to take over from there in Jesus' name. To give our lesson, I hope you. We may be seated. We may be seated. Amen. Praise the name of the Lord. Thank God for this day. Thank God for this cold weather. Amen. Are you happy that you are healthy and you are here to worship the Lord? Yes. Hallelujah. Amen. So let me start by appreciating the servant of God, our pastor. Thank you so much, our pastor, and thank you so much for taking us through. Thank you, because we are here to worship God, to hear his word, and even to see each other and to fellowship one with another is a blessing. Amen. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. With us is our mom, this is Bishop Irungu. We thank God for you, mom. We really acknowledge your presence. I also want to thank God for my wife. She's also with us, and we thank God that he has brought us this far. I know my wife has not spoken for us or to us for a long time. I will give her a chance one of these days, and she will speak to us. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I thank God for what is happening to our Sunday school. Slowly by slowly, we are bringing them in the ways of God. I believe that at home, that is what we are doing. And may the name of the Lord be praised. I personally thank God because of Joshua. He blessed us many times when we were in a lockdown. And I see him being a servant of God, even in the future that we behold. So for me, if he becomes a servant of God, I really will have, not looking for an engineer in him or whatever it is. He may become those other things, but if as a parent, then I can make him love God and serve God, I think I will have achieved a lot. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
So parents, I'm saying this just to encourage us. It is not easy. It is not easy, and you must be very tough on your child because of influence, because of the environment we are living in. But just be tough, because you have gone before them. You know a bit of life more than them. And so instruction must continue. Amen?
Amen.
Instruction must continue. Do not let down your levels of instruction. And we thank God, because we know very soon we are going back to school. Hallelujah. Our children are going back to school. Our friends, our family members are going back to college. We thank God because, we are seeing the levels going down. And I want to thank God because I believe it is because God loves us as a nation. God loves Africa. Amen. You remember Africa was a place of refuge. Even when they wanted to kill Jesus, they say, no, go to Egypt until the time is fulfilled for this child. Amen. So we are a unique continent, and we thank God for what is happening. We bless the Lord. One of these days, you will just wake up, you will look for news about this coronavirus, and probably we will be hearing it elsewhere, and we will thank God. Amen. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. So welcome to our service today. This is the second service. And I want you to get tuned in the spirit. I know most times when we come, it's the second service. Sometimes, it's just when the day is turning. But tune yourself in the spirit so that you may receive what the Lord has for us at this particular season of our lives. One of the first things that I want us to know is that in Jeremiah chapter number 1, which is now the last season of the year, Jeremiah chapter 1 and verse 11,
verse 11, probably we can read that. I think that is where, because our year started with visitation, favor, then we are finishing with the year with fulfillment. Can you say amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. Fulfillment. We are going into fulfillment. And God is hastening His word to fulfill it in the life of the believer who believes in Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. And I believe we are all here because we believe the Lord Jesus. And so I want us to just start in there, Jeremiah chapter 1, verse 11 and 12, and then we will go to the main topic of our day, Jeremiah chapter 1 and verse 12. This is what the Bible says. I will read it. Moreover, the word of the Lord came unto me, saying, Jeremiah, what seest thou? And I said, I see a rod of an almond tree. Then said the Lord unto me, thou hast well seen, for I will hasten my word to perform it. Now, the fulfillment of the word of God comes with a confirmation of sight, of things you see in your life, of things that I see in my life. And then they are connected to the word of God. And then God says, what you see, those are the things that I will hasten. I will make them happen faster in your life. So I want to announce to us as a fellowship, Gospel Revival Center Kangemi, that we have now entered into that season. Do not be left behind. May your spiritual eyes begin to see what God has put for you. And when you see them in the spirit, just like Jeremiah said, I see an almond tree. Then God says, you have seen correctly. Because there are people who are seeing things, and those things they are seeing are not the correct ones. Probably you are seeing destruction, you are seeing no hope and all that. And I pray as we enter together as a family, each one of us will begin to see what the Lord has prepared for us. How do you see the things that God has prepared for you? You enter into the spirit. You begin a lifestyle of prayer. And that is why I'm calling for us, and we have just been given the announcement that we will now intentionally go into prayers. Praying about your life, personal life, praying about your family and the family of God in this place, our nation, and the Lord surely shall do great things. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Wangapi wanaamini ya kwamba Mungu atatenda mambo makubwa. Hallelujah. Mimi ninaamini kabisa tumeingia katika majira hayo ya Mungu kukamilisha yale ambao amesema kwa neno lake. Na anakamilisha kwa sababu amefanya agano na sisi kupitia mwanae Yesu. Amen. Praise the name of the Lord. So please tap into this, because you will see others receiving, and it will not be fun when you ask, why am I receiving? Because when God speaks and intends to do things, then He gives us a lane to run. So there is a run, that a race to run for me and you. Let us do it, and the Lord shall bless us. Amen. Amen. Praise the name of the Lord. Let us go to the study of the word of God today. The Lord has given me a message and by His Spirit, and the message is entitled, your situation needs restoration. Your situation needs restoration. In Jesus' mighty name. And the scripture that we are going to read is found in the book of Luke, chapter number 4 and chapter number 5. Well, we will read Luke chapter number 4 from verse number 38, and then we will go into Luke chapter number 5 all the way from verse number 1 to verse number 11, and the Lord shall bless us. Amen. Now, restoration, urejesho ni kusema namna gani? Urejesho kumaanisha Mungu anatazamia kutenda jambo katika maisha yako ambao hilo jambo lilikuwapo. Ni kwamba jambo kuna jambo kuna hali ambayo ilikuwa katika maisha yangu kuna jambo ama hali ambayo ilikuwepo katika maisha yangu ikawa ni ya baraka ikawa ni ya kunipa ushindi ikawa ni ya kunipatia kuendelea ikawa ndio desturi ya maisha yangu lakini hilo jambo limezimia limefifia ama limetoweka ama halipatikani tena. When you speak about restoration, you are saying God is healing a part of my life. God is healing a part of your life that was there. There are things in your life, my sister. There are things in your life, my brother, that are actually almost dead. They are not there. Others are almost, they are fainting away. Others you just remember, you only have memories about them. But this is the word that the Lord has given me. And I believe as you tap into this this word, because it is the word, the most important word you need to capture in the spirit is restoration. Restoration. That there is something God wants to restore in your life. There is something that God wants to restore in my life. And the first step of restoration is healing. Is healing. Kuna uponyaji. And I want to announce to the church of God and to the church of Jesus Christ and to you, my brother, my sister, whoever you are and wherever you are watching us from, that there is healing that is coming your way because God is aligning your life for restoration. God is aligning my life for restoration. And I am tapping to this word because it is not just the word of God. It is the word that is born in the spirit. It is an announcement from the spirit that if you tap it, the Lord shall restore what belongs to you. Amen. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. So restoration brings back life. Amen. Restoration is bringing back to life that which is dead. Restoration is bringing back to productivity that which now does not profit anymore. Restoration is bringing back to life and to breakthroughs that which currently is seen as useless. And the Lord Jesus Christ is going to do it in our lives, brethren, in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. When I received this word, I got excited because I know we are living in that moment where a lot of us have lost and we are in situations that actually need restoration in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. So as we begin to read the scriptures, I want you to open up to the Lord Jesus. I want you to be honest to the Lord Jesus. I want you to respond to this word in obedience. Because if you do not feel that this is the word, or probably you feel that you can still push on with life on your own, or you feel still, bado ninaweza kuendelea na maisha ninamane, labda nisukume vile nimejipangia maisha, labda hautapata mafanikio ya urejesho katika maisha yako. And that is why I am believing God that by this word and when we receive it by faith and go forward and begin to call upon the name of the Lord for restoration, it shall happen in our lives in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. I know we will read the word and you will see it. It is very important to be honest. Sometimes it is whatever is happening in our families, whatever is happening in our places of work or in your business, sometimes you put a brave face and you say, you know, pastor, you know, servant of God, you know, all is well. But I know because God has given us this word, there is one thing I know that God always does. And I want to let you know before we read the scriptures is that Mungu daima huwa anatufikiria mema. Hakuna mtu ambaye anakufikiria mema kama Mungu wetu. I know one time, you know, probably from where you work, you know, a meeting was called, a letter has been written, and probably right now you are not working. And things have really not been very good. We have read we have read in the news ya kwamba almost 2 million Kenyans have actually lost their jobs. And you think that is good news? It is not good news. It is affecting our brothers. It is affecting our friends. It is affecting our families. And I'm here to say, and I'm here to just speak the word of God that there is coming your way restoration in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Bwana ana mpango mzuri. The Bible says God has a good plan, and the thoughts that he thinks about you and me are thoughts of success to give you your expected end in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Si tuseme amen hata kama kuna baridi. Hallelujah. Now, Luke chapter number 4, verse 38. I want us to read together. I am excited that the Lord is restoring some things in my life. And I know that, yes, even you, the Lord is bringing restoration in Jesus' name. Amen. Number 38, the Bible says, and he arose out of the synagogue and entered into Simon's house. I want you to underline Simon's house, because you will see Simon now is becoming a person of interest. And I pray that my brother, my sister, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, that the Lord, from wherever you are, I may not know you, from the ends of the earth, I don't know where you are, that the Lord will be interested in your affairs, and he will come your way, even for restoration in Jesus' name. The Bible says, Jesus in verse number 38, he is in the synagogue, he is teaching, and sometimes we think that good things that must happen in the church. It is true, the good things that happen most times in the church. But Jesus gets attention of the life of Simon. And I pray that the Lord shall get an attention ataguzwa na maisha ambayo wewe unapitia wakati huu. Na Mungu akiguzwa na maisha ambayo unapitia wakati huu, atafanya amuzi ya kuja mpaka kufika kwa nyumba yako. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. And he arose out of the synagogue and he entered into Simon's house. And Simon's wife's mother was taken with a great fever, and they besought him for her. And he stood over her and rebuked the fever, and it left her. And immediately she arose and ministered unto them. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Hallelujah. Now the Lord really ministers to us differently. When the word of God came unto me about restoration and took me to Luke number chapter 5, I went into Luke number 4 and I didn't know what I was looking for. And I realized, one Yesu asifiwe, I realized that Simon has an issue. One Yesu asifiwe. Ya kwamba mambo ambayo yanatendeka katika Luka mlango wa 5 yameanza katika Luka mlango wa 4. Biblia inasema ya kwamba Yesu akatoka kwa dhehebu, akatoka kwenye hekalu, na kuna jambo mami anasema na wacha niende. Hakuwa amealikwa. Biblia inasema kwamba alitoka tu kwa hekalu na akaingia katika nyumba ya Simon. And you will see that Simon's life needed restoration, and it was restored. And that is why I'm saying, my brother, my sister, if you hear this word and you be honest with your life and say, yes, Father, I need restoration. Kuna hali za maisha yangu ambazo zimezimia. Kuna mambo maisha yangu ambayo kabisa sasa hivi haya. The Lord is coming our way. The Lord is coming your way. In Jesus' mighty name, there is going to be restoration. Kuna wapendwa ambao pia wamekaa nyumbani, ni wapendwa walokole, walikuwa wameokoka, alafu wamekaa nyumbani lockdown, wameona maisha yamebadilika, hawaoni kama Mungu anatupenda tena, na wamekaa nyumbani wanasema kuna haja gani kwenda kanisani kama Mungu ametupitisha hivi mpaka mambo yetu yakazimia hivi mpaka usiku na mchana mambo yetu yamesambaratika. Lakini listen to me, child of God, from wherever you are, the Lord loves you still, the Lord knows you, and like Simon, he is leaving the synagogue and he is making way to your house in the mighty name of Jesus. And the number one step of restoration is healing in Jesus' mighty name. Mungu anataka kupone ili kwamba arejeshe hali za maisha yangu na arejeshe hali za maisha yako. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. So he is intentional. He says, let me go and let me find what is happening in the house of Simon. In Jesus' mighty name, we read number 39. And he stood over her, rebuked the fever, and it left her. And immediately she arose and ministered unto them. Hallelujah. Verse number 40, the Bible says, now when the sun was setting, all they that had sick with diverse diseases brought them unto him, and he laid his hands on every one of them, and he healed them. He healed them. I like the ministry of Jesus. Mimi napenda huduma ya Kristo. Ya kwamba Kristo hakuwa anaombea watu tu. Yani Mungu ndani ya maisha yetu haleti tu ule uwepo wa kusikia vizuri. He is touched. The Bible says in the book of Hebrews, ya kwamba Jesus is touched with the feeling of our infirmities. Infirmities come and destroy our businesses. Our infirmities come and destroy the progress of our lives. There is something that you wanted to do this year. No wonder others are saying 2020 should be scrapped out of the calendar. Let me tell you, my 2020 still remains. My year is still intact. In Jesus' mighty name. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Now, by the way, there are things, my brother, my sister, that have happened over time. When you hear 1.8 million losing jobs, and you see them in our community, and we have been affected, because when they are affected, we are infected, because in one way or the other, well, then we must support them, and it has not been easy. Hallelujah. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. And there must be something. Lazima kuna hali ndani ya maisha yako, ndani ya maisha yangu ambao kabisa ninaona Mungu hali hii inahitaji urejesho. Hallelujah. It is a pumping back of life into a situation that has been there. It is the restoration means God speaking a blessing to a place where people have thought you have been cursed and it has dried up. A business that is not doing well, or a situation in your family or children that are beginning to go wayward, and you are wondering, what shall happen to my life? What shall happen to my family? What shall happen to my wife? And what shall happen to my husband? I say here in the morning, ya kwamba kuna a friend ambaye aliniambia, you know, they got small children that came into their place, and they are saying, mama ametuacha, alituacha tangu wakati wa corona. Yeye alitoka tu kwa nyumba na akaenda. Imagine a woman who has children, has left the children on their own, and she has walked away, and she has gone, and when they have her conduct is no longer there, they don't know where she went, and they were looking for food, and that is what is happening in our community. And husbands have left their families, men have left their families, and women have been left alone, and to fend for their children. So the situation in our lives, there is a situation in your life, there is a situation in my life that is not easy, and it is that, those are the facts that we are going through. But I thank God, because the word of God always will come, because God has decided to begin to visit our lives again with restoration in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Hatuwezi kunena mambo yote ambayo yanatendeka. I'm telling you, it is not enough to just put a bright or a bold face. I saw a teacher ambaye alikuwa anasema, mimi nilikuwa na shule na tukaingia pale na mke wangu, maana hatungeweza kulipa nyumba ya rent, na tukaendelea ikawa hata ni vigumu sasa kupata chakula, and I looked at an owner of a school. Sasa ikisemekana ya kwamba anauza sweets, sijui kama uliona story kama hii. I saw it in the news, and that is just one out of the many. Ya kwamba you are in a school, you own a school, you cannot even keep your family. Now it gets to a level where the family has to go back home, and now you are selling sweets in the road. That is why when you see people selling things, just buy if you have enough, because they are looking for the next meal. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Asifiwe Yesu kanisa. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. It is. This is the word, and the Lord is going to do something in our lives and in our nation, because our nation needs healing. Our nation needs healing. Amen. Amen. Number 41. Now I want us to read number 40, because we'll go into number 5, chapter number 5. Now the Bible says, now when the sun was setting, all they that had sick Any sick with diverse diseases brought them unto him, and he laid his hands on every one of them, and he healed them. So Jesus did not just pray and send people away. I want that to get into our hearts, Church of Jesus, that Jesus did not just offer prayers. Jesus was concerned with the affairs of those people that came to him. So if you needed a miracle, Jesus prayed and he did the miracle. And what we see now here is in the house, he has started in the house of Simon. And when he is well, he's still there. People hear that he has healed the mother-in-law of Simon. And so the Bible says, then they bring all manner of people that all had all manner of diseases. And Jesus, because he is the healer and he knows restoration begins with the healing, then he laid his hands on each one of them, and the people that came to him were healed of all diseases in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Na kwa hivyo wapendwa, tunapotamka kuhusu urejesho, na kanisa la Yesu tunapotamka kuhusu urejesho, jambo la kwanza ambalo lazima litendeke ndani ya maisha yetu ni uponyaji. Na ninahisi na ninasikia ya kwamba kwa imani tunapokea uponyaji katika maisha yetu. Na unaweza kuuliza, chungaji, ni uponyaji wa aina gani? Let me tell you, kama kuna ugonjwa ambao umeshika wenzetu, ukashika marafiki zetu, ukashika wale ambao tunafanya kazi na wao, wale ambao tunafanya biashara na wao, ni ugonjwa wa mawazo. Depression is killing, and people are thinking like, I can throw myself down, I can take these drugs and call it a day. I come to tell you in the name of Jesus that he has come your way. If you actually want, if you surrender yourself to Jesus, even as a child of God, because we may think it is all well, even in the house of God, but it is not well. And that is why Jesus is coming with an intention to restore. Now, by your jambo la kwanza kanisa, I speak healing in Jesus' name over your life and over your life and your body. That which has taken away joy, ya kwamba wezi kucheka tena, wezi kufurahia maisha tena, katika jina la Yesu, huyu Mungu tunayeabudu analeta uponyaji njia yako katika jina la Yesu. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You know, let me tell you, the reason why healing is important, the reason why healing is important, there are people who have been affected, they are sickly in such a way that even if you told them to go back to their businesses, he cannot. There are people that have begun to hate what they used to do, and it is a mental problem. It is a situation in their life, and they are hating everyone. And they are beginning to say, this is the one who did this, this is the one who caused this. And that is why healing must first happen, so that when God begins to restore your business, he is restoring a business to a healed soul that has joy and the strength to accomplish the things that God is bringing you away.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. You know, I saw in the morning, even when we are singing and dancing for the Lord, do you think we are dancing and dancing to the Lord like we used to? What is causing that heaviness? Amen. You know, COVID-19 has brought a situation where people are giving up on life. There is no test again for life. You know, the social and what God has given us, the joy of the Lord, which is our strength and which we must, you know, pursue every day. And when you see, we are, of course, we gather in the church and we are dancing, but you see, we have a limitation, and the enemy is a liar. In the mighty name of Jesus, we are getting healed. My brother, my sister, you are getting healed in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Bwana Yesu
asifiwe. Me, I know, I know. know, I have convinced certain people to go to church. You cannot imagine. You are convincing some people that I know that were even being used of God. They are sleeping and lying on their couches on a Sunday. There is no longer any more test of fellowship, and when you wonder what is happening with this brother, what is happening with this sister, it is because we need healing. The things that we have gone through, and you'd rather not say, my brother, usiniambie mchungaji, mimi mambo yangu yako sawa, hakuna haliye, because this word is coming to us and it is coming to you. There is no one who can say all things in my life are okay. I want to tell you, my brother, my sister, your situation, my situation needs restoration. We need God to take us back to our moments of joy. We need God to take us to our moments of victory, where we could have moments of praise together with our families, where we had projects and we say, oh, I am believing God is so good, this project is gonna end in this and this particular time. Hallelujah. Begin to believe again. Amen. Begin to believe God again. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. So, verse number 41. There is always a demonic, and listen to me, there is always a demonic, a powerful force, the forces of evil that are holding us down. And they are telling us, let us sing the song of COVID-19. Let us sing the song of 2020 should not be in the calendar. Oh, let us sing this and the other that now, that, and let us lift our hands up and say it is gone. Let me tell you, it is time to arise as a child of God and say no to the situations of my life. I will arise, and the enemy, the Lord of Lords, who I worship, and his name is Jesus, is rebuking every devil, every demon in my life, every whisper that is saying I am going down, every word that has been spoken against my life, it is the Lord is rebuking the works of the enemy in my life, because he is paving way for restoration. Amen. Hallelujah. That is why number 41, the Bible says, and devils also came out of many, crying out and saying, thou art Christ, the Son of God. And he, rebuking them, suffered them not to speak, for they knew that he was Christ. Hallelujah. Why were they saying, you are the Son of God, Christ, the Son of God? Because he is the anointed one, and the anointing of God in your life, and the anointing of Jesus in our lives, is the anointing that is going to break every yoke of heaviness, every yoke of defeat, every yoke of giving up and lifting up your hands. And you are saying, now me, my issues are gone, and now I am given up. There is no giving up, Church of Jesus, child of God, my friend, from wherever you are, there is no giving up. If you surrender your situation to Jesus, if I surrender my situation to Jesus, I know all shall be well in Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise the name of the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. Refuse, my brother, to throw up your hands, saying, whatever will be, will be. Whatever will be, will be. No! Refuse to throw up your hands. Hallelujah. Can I get an amen? Amen. Refuse to throw up your hands. If there was something that you are believing God for, it is the window of fulfillment in the mighty name of Jesus. And he is fulfilling it because he is sending restoration your way.
Amen.
Refuse to throw up your hands. Hiyo niliachana nani. Hata usinikumbushe. Ni tulikuwa tunaamini hata sasa simu mwaka umeisha. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And I want to correct something. I know probably, of course, when we the man's coming, we give them names and signs, and we say this is now the man of. Please look unto Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
It is not the man, it is Jesus. Hallelujah. It is not the man and what the man denotes and all that. It is Jesus. That is why people come into a man, then the man goes and your life remains the same. I am speaking to us and saying, as children of God, let us look unto Jesus, the author and the perfecter of our faith. Hallelujah. So refuse to say, I am giving up. You are looking for a college education. You are looking for a job. And you know the situation currently does not even allow us to get jobs. Who has a job? Where? Where is the job? When people are getting dismissed from their places of work. But child of God, listen and take this word of God. Na useme mimi nimesikia neno la Mungu. Nawe Yesu umesema wewe ndio unarejesha. Kwanza nataka uniponye. All of us who are even seated here, I pray for healing in the name of Jesus. I don't know which life part of your life and which part. It could be your body, it could be your spirit, it could be issues of the soul, because there are people who walk around born again but with bitterness in their hearts. I pray that in Jesus' name that the Lord shall begin to heal you, and you begin to say to the Lord, I am seeking for you. Kwa sababu yetu ni kwambie, man will come and go. Let me tell you, man will come and go. But let us look unto Jesus and tell Jesus, my time has come. Oh, restore this business. Restore this fortune. I have planned this, Jehovah God. And it doesn't matter, the enemy has come, because it is not, sicknesses don't come from God. They are not from God. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Sicknesses don't come from God. And that is why we cannot say, oh God, now. No. He allowed it. But we are winning over this. Amen.
Amen.
Bwana Yesu asifiwe.
Amen.
We are winning in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. So it is Jesus. We must look unto Jesus. Because Jesus is the same. The Bible says, Hebrews chapter number 13, from number 13 and verse 8, He is the same yesterday, today, and forever. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Kwa hivyo mpendwa, uponyaji unakuja katika maisha yako. Now please, we are going to read in number 5. Be honest with yourself. Yani mwambie Mungu, mimi nahitaji niponye. Mimi niponye jambo hili, hali hizi ambazo zimenisonga, nahitaji uponyaji wako. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. So he cast out devils in number 41. And you read now what is happening in verse number 42 and 43. Because the people were healed. Devils were cast out of their lives. And when those two things happen in any man, anywhere in the world, they will have a free will to follow the Lord and to hear his word. Hallelujah. There is nothing that hinders God in our lives like a life that is of sickness. You are sick, you are, you know, confused life, you don't know, you are depressed, you are living in a life of heaviness. You will not hear God. And that is why Jesus had to heal first. And then he cast devils out of the people. And then number 5, because we must finish, the Bible says, and it came to pass, as the people pressed upon him to hear the word of God, now they have been healed. Devils have been removed from many of them. And they are saying, this is the man to follow. So there were many. The Bible says, he stood by the lake of Gennesaret. He stood by the lake of Gennesaret and saw two sheep standing by the lake. But the fishermen were gone out of them and were washing their nets. They had gone out of them, just like you and me. We have gone out of our situations. We have gone out of our family, our family altars, and we have gone out. We have said, oh, it's not happening anymore. And we have gone out of our businesses. There is something, my brother, my sister, that you can intentionally, you can say, kabisa mimi hali hii nimeiachilia. Nimeacha sasa bwana, hata sitaki kuikumbuka tena. And the Bible says they were washing their nets. Those are two indicators in the mighty name of Jesus that you need the Lord Jesus to restore your life. Ukiona maishani mako umeanza, umetoka katika chombo, umetoka kati, hata unaosha nyafu, unasema hizi, sasa hata sijui kama itawezekana tena. In essence, what the Bible, ama kwa namna nyingine vile Biblia inavyosema, ni kwamba hawa wawili, hawa wavuvi wa samaki, walikuwa wamekata tamaa. Alikuwa amesema haiwezekani tena. Wacha tuende nyumbani. Wacha hata tusikize, maana labda walikuwa karibu. Ukiangalia hali hii,
speak of number 4 na number 5 unaona kabisa wao walisema ah acha tusikie vile anavyosema na wakasema acha basi tuoshe nyafu. Kuosha nyafu si kumaanisha umepata faida, kuosha nyafu ni kumaanisha wewe sasa ushuhuda wako ni nimeanguka, ushuhuda wako ni haiwezekani, ushuhuda wako ni kwamba labda hii hakuna kitu tena, maisha hayawezekani tena. Acha hiyo ushuhuda, jisongeshe ama get closer to the Lord who restores our lives and is going to restore you in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. I am not going to wash my hands because I have heard the word of God. I am going to go back to my vessel and I am going to wait upon God for restoration in Jesus' name. Kile ambacho Mungu aliweka ndani ya maisha yangu, kile ambacho aliweka ndani ya maisha yako kitakuja kutendeka, si kwa sababu ya experience yako, si kwa sababu ya masomo yangu, si kwa sababu ya kule nimetoka na kule nimezaliwa. It is because He wants to restore your life. He wants to restore your life. He is a good God. He is a loving Father. He wants your life to have taste and is restoring that taste right now in Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. Verse number 3, the Bible says, and he entered into one of the ships, which was Simon's, and prayed him that he would thrust into out a little from the land. Amen. Praise the name of the Lord. Now I want you to see the connection here. The first house to visit, the first house for Jesus to visit was the house of Simon. And that is what I saw when I read number 5. And then I went back, something just told me, go back to number 4. And then I see, kumbe Jesus started in the house of Simon. The mother was sick. And that is where Jesus, started. And when he comes to the lake of Gennesaret, then the Bible says he sees these two men. They are washing, they are out of their vessels, their boats, and they are washing their nets. They have given up. They have given up. And he says, give me one. And he says, this one for Simon. Because he has something to do with the life of Simon. Hallelujah. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. I pray for a revelation to this word in your life. That God is looking at you not as a church. When God begins to visit my life, He will visit me as Samuel. He will visit you as George. He will visit you as Mutua or Wanjiku. He becomes personal. He says, yes, I know. Kumbe, that is why Simon at home, there was sickness. When he goes to his business, there is nothing he is getting. Have you been into those situations, my brother? Unatoka nyumbani, nyumbani kumekaa red, sema red. Yani hali za nyumbani zimekaa vibaya. Unatoka tu unasema wacha niende nikajaribu kama itawezekana. Hata kwa biashara unapata haiwezekani. That was the situation of brother Simon. He was at home, there was sickness. At home there was, you know, there was the mother who was sick. And when he went to, because the Bible actually says, it doesn't say Simon, he is the one who said, please deal with my mom. My mother-in-law. The Bible says the people that had come with Jesus, they besought Jesus to heal the mother-in-law for Simon. So Simon is in the sea and he is struggling and he is trying. And the Bible says, because you will see it in number 5, that they told him, Master, we have toiled the whole night and day. You know, these were fishermen, men that knew the experience of the sea. There comes a time, my brother, my sister, it doesn't matter your experience in life. It comes a time when you must begin to say, I will bow to the Creator of all things because He is the one who is able to restore my life. Jesus knows that Simon is experienced. He has been in the sea for the day. He has been in the sea for the night. And Simon is saying, I hatujapata chochote. Hallelujah. So time has come, church. We put aside our experience. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Yeah. You know how to do those things. Yes. That is the business you have done for years. And you know how to plus one, minus one, and this, and where to get this and the other. But it's not working. It is time for restoration. I say, church, your situation needs restoration. Even as a servant of God, Hallelujah. There are things we have learned how to do them, and then this and then the result, and this lockdown and this pandemic has come, and things have changed. And you must be honest even as a servant of God and say, surely the way I used to know things and do things, oh Lord, I have no experience anymore. I need you to now begin with me afresh. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. Praise the name of the Lord. One of the things that I see in the world today is that those men and servants of God, you know, we were used to many people, many programs, and even with the few things, allowances that we've been given to go back to church, we still feel we need our numbers. Listen to me, servant of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Your situation needs restoration. It doesn't matter. I know we've had, you know, bishops, and you have a big title, and you are a prophet to the nations, and you are an anointed servant of God. And I think our ego doesn't allow us to speak and to speak the word of God to small numbers. Please, take your situation to Jesus before, because you do not know what has happened while we were in lockdown. We all need the Lord Jesus. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah. The Bible says number 4. I want us just to read number 3, 4, and then because we must finish. And he entered into one of the ships, which was Simon's. Now look at that. From home to Simon's business to Simon's affairs. Amen. Do not say, Lord, what is at home you can deal with, and what is in my place of work, please let me handle it. Restoration is about your whole facet of life. Yani maisha yangu yote, toka kwa boma, toka vyote vilivyo navyo. You know, some of us now, probably you had money, you had accounts that had money. Right now, there's nothing. The Lord wants to restore your fortunes in Jesus' name. So let him be in your life, the restorer of your life. Hallelujah. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Hallelujah. Amen. Simon had prayed him that he brought a little from the land, and he sat down and taught the people out of the ship. Now, when he had left speaking, he said unto Simon, he is moving with Simon. And this is, it's like a roadmap to my restoration and to your restoration. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Hallelujah. Ninaomba Bwana akusaidie ya kwamba ufuate maagizo haya, because many times even as a church and as a children of God, we come into the house of God, we hear powerful word and message, alafu maana ni roadmap, ukifuata itakufikisha kwa urejesho wako. Angalia vile ambavyo ameanzana na Simon, anamwambia nipe chombo chako kidogo, anamwambia hebu sukuma kidogo. You know, let me tell you my sister, yani kule kugumiza moyo, my brother, kule kugumiza moyo, there are some small things the Lord is telling you. He has been speaking to you during this lockdown. Mpatie kidogo, mpatie huyo jirani. You have seen your neighbor suffer, and the other one, and the other one. And the Lord has been saying, ebu kidogo, nipe, ebu isukume hii chombo kidogo, ili niweze kupata nafasi ya kuwahubiria watu. Alikuwa anaangalia moyo wa Simon, ni moyo wa namna gani. Maana kuna wengi wakati urejesho unakuja, even when the Lord wants to heal us, the very first small instruction of the Lord, you push it aside. Unasema mimi siwezi kufanya hivi, hata mimi walikuwa wapi, mimi you start giving all these kind of things. And there's nothing so terrible than wakati haujapata kitu na Mungu, na mtu anakuja kwa hiyo jambo lako hata anataka pia. I want you to look at the situation of Simon. He has not gotten fish. And the Lord is saying, I want to use your vessel. And he tells him, I don't not only want to use it, but I want you to push it a bit so that I can use it as I preach. Then the Bible says, number four, now when he had left speaking, he said unto Simon, let me tell you, listen to what the Lord is going to tell you in the next few months that we are going to have for this year. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Be very attentive to the Spirit of God. Na ndio sababu tunasema wapendwa, it is not now to the servant of God. Ati unge hapa ili kwamba mimi nijue hali za maisha yako. Be personal with your life and begin to say, I will go to God in prayer and I will begin to listen and obey his word, and what he instructs me to do, that shall I do. That is what Simon is doing. Even though hajapata chochote, Simon sasa hivi anaweza kuambiwa kwamba yeye hana kazi. Alikuwa katika hali ya kwamba hana kazi, hajapata samaki, ako katika point of depressed, you know, being depressed. He has nothing. He has nothing to, you know, around him. And he knows, anajua hata nyumbani alipata, but I'm sure he had been told that the mother now is healed. But now he is in a situation where he cannot do any more good. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Hallelujah. We have people in the church who are saying, pastor should understand. Men of God, you should understand. Hatuna kazi, hatuna, nataka tuje kazi, tuje kanisani aje. Nataka tuombe aje. Mtu ataomba aje kama tumbo haina chakula. Have you had those kind of things? There are people who are saying, why do you want us to serve God and our stomachs have nothing? And then we are passing through pain and all these things. I tell you, that is the way for your restoration. That is the way to your restoration. Amen. Now when he has left speaking, and the Lord will watch, and the Lord will be in your life for a moment, even for a time frame. Hallelujah. Maana hakuna jambo katika maisha yangu na hakuna jambo katika maisha yako ni ya milele. Sema amen. Hakuna jambo ambalo ni la milele, ndugu yangu, dada yangu. It shall also come to pass. Amen. And then he says, launch out into the deep and let down your net for a draught. So this was not Jesus telling him, probably you will get fish. Now that you have helped me, try and see whether you get sheep. He was speaking to his situation, and he was saying, now Simon, because I have followed you from home, I have brought healing into your home, and now into your profession, into the works of your hands, I am bringing restoration. Let down your nets for a drought. Wewe hujaona kitu kigumu, ndugu yangu, kwenda kuchukua kile kitu ulikuwa umeacha. The nets that you had dried up, uingie katika kile chombo, and you are saying the same kiosk, the same business servant of God, the same situation in my family. Are you telling me to go to the same project that was niliacha kitambo na nikasahau? Let me tell you, yes. The Lord is instructing us during this window of time that we must go back to the place where we left it all, where we said it cannot happen, because he has commanded revival. The Lord has commanded restoration, and he only wants you to take a step of faith and get back to that situation and speak to that situation the word of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Bwana asifiwe. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Because we live here, and then you go to a situation in your place or in your personal life, and then what the enemy does, he makes sure this mouth will not speak. He will speak about something else. Oh, we are very good at speaking about those things, isn't it? See, we can speak them from morning to evening. But then the things that concern the command for your revival, the things that concern the command for your restoration, we don't speak. So God is telling us this week we are beginning prayers, and this is restoration. So you are going to take your situation, and you are going to say, the word of the Lord has commanded restoration. You shall be restored. And wait upon God there, and the Lord will prove himself faithful. Amen. Look at what Simon is saying. And Simon answering, saying that way, Master, we have toiled all night and have taken nothing. Nevertheless, at thy word, will I let down the net. Let's stand up on our feet. Let's stand up on our feet. Simon,
is a man of experience. Simon is a professional. Simon knows how to do business. Simon is not a young man. He's not just emotional about what he's talking to Jesus. He's saying, Jesus, listen, we have toiled day and night. Now, restoration will change the circumstance of your life. You know, ordinarily fish would come. And if you talk to fishermen, they do it at night. Amen? Wanavua usiku. But look at when Jesus, he had finished speaking. And of course, he did not finish speaking at night, because he had to let people go back to their homes. Simon anasema, Bwana, nimejaribu. I don't know what your situation is, child of God. I have a situation that I have tried. A testimony will be given. I think we will give this testimony about tomorrow. That, yes, there are things that you will look for and you will say, But we saw it with our eyes this last week as the fulfillment of what Bishop used to say here. It was just happening in our eyes about mom and family. That is why we must now arise and accomplish it. Praise the name of the Lord. I have toiled the whole night. Nevertheless, at your word, I will let down the net. Now, we are spiritual. I want you to close your eyes. When they had this done, they enclosed a great multitude of fishes, and their net broke. Go and read. Because the end of it, Simon is saying, get away from me, Jesus, because I am a sinful man. When restoration comes, my sister, you will realize, na mimi nitagundua nilikuwa nang'ang'ana peke yangu, ya kwamba nguvu zangu hazikuwa zinahitajika, kwamba experience yangu haikuwa inahitajika. And I'm releasing you in Jesus' name. Begin to talk to the Lord as we come to the close of this service. I'm releasing you before the Lord. Just open your mouth and begin to talk to God. I know we have spoken and we have said, let down the net. I don't know. But just begin to speak to the Lord in Jesus' name. Mwambie Bwana mimi hali yangu hii nairejesha kwako. Nairejesha kwako. Some of you probably hata huna nguvu za kusema Bwana hiki na kile, lakini kwa neno lako nitafanya. And this is what I'm instructing you, my brother, my sister. It is not just the word in the book of Luke chapter number 5. But there is a word that the Holy Spirit will speak to you concerning your situation. That is the word that you must let down into the deep. It is not Luke number 5 and verse number 5 only. The Lord is going to speak to you, my brother, my sister, concerning your family, concerning that business, concerning your situation. And when he speaks to you, that is the word. That is the word that you will let down into the deep in prayer. In the name of Jesus. Lift up your head before the Lord and begin to thank him and tell him, Lord, thank you for this word. I wait upon you for restoration. I wait upon you for restoration. In the mighty name of Jesus, there is a word that is coming your way. That is a word that is coming your way. If you are spiritual, if your spirit feel in the name of Jesus, kuna neno, tutakapoanza maombi na tunaanza sasa hivi. Ndio neno ambalo liko mstari wa tano. Lilikuwa ni neno la mvuvi Simon. Na maana yeye alikuwa na nyavu zake na chombo chake. Akasema Bwana umenena, tumesema, tumefanya usiku na mchana, lakini hata hivyo kwa sababu ya neno lako. Oh, you shall hear the word of God, my sister. When you hear the word of God, drop it into the deep of your spirit and begin to call upon the Lord, and God shall restore you. He is restoring your fortune. He is restoring. has fed the hungry. He knew, he healed the sick. He demonstrated respect for women and children in the mighty name of Jesus. He met the needs of the people that were in front of him. And Jesus is meeting your need, my brother. He is meeting your needs, my sister. He is calling you Simon. That is why he is calling you Simon. In the mighty name of Jesus, it is your time. It is your season of fulfillment, church. Hallelujah. Who can say, Simon, Gospel Bible Center, come get it. It is your time for fulfillment. In the name of Jesus, restoration, my brother. You can replace Simon with your name and say, it is my turn. Oh, drop this word in my spirit. Holy Ghost, I will wait upon you. I will wait upon you for our nation. I will wait upon you for our land and our leaders. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. Restore the fortunes of this land. In Jesus' mighty name. In Jesus' mighty name. In Jesus' mighty name. In Jesus' mighty name. You have tried your own efforts. You have tried your own things. You have tried men and they have failed you. You have tried experience and they have failed you. It is time for restoration. I speak a word of restoration. In your life today, in Jesus' mighty name, receive it and begin this journey. And I hear and I speak a testimony. You will come back and say, I called my brother James. I called my brother John. It was too much for me. I called them. They came and helped me out. You will be the solution for that failing family, that crumbling economy of nations. You will be the solution. You will call and you will partner with others. I speak the anointing after restoration to partner, because we are not called to be selfish. May the Lord make you rich to partner with others in the kingdom, and that the word of God may be fulfilled in our lives. That God spoke to Abraham and he told him, I will make you a blessing, and through you all the families of the world shall be blessed. In Jesus' name. Give up, lift up your hands and bless the Lord in the mighty name.